Hello and welcome. This is Chandni Nevdani and you are watching It's Tomorrow News. As the exact track of Major Hurricane Dorian is becoming more certain, with a strike along the central Florida Atlantic coast, the most probable outcome, the tropical cyclone, is likely to unleash torrential rain and raise the risk of flooding after landfall next week. Following major impact to lives and property due to high winds and coastal flooding, heavy rain and inland flooding may be Dorian's second wind over the southeastern United States. There are a few weather features that will affect the track of Dorian and the amount of rainfall that is released as it moves along through next week. The first is relatively common among areas of high pressure over the west central Atlantic. A clockwise flow around this high is in part directing Dorian on its current northwest path. A second feature is a large storm in the middle layer of the atmosphere over the Caribbean. That is not so common. The counterclockwise flow around this storm is also pushing Dorian to the northwest. Dorian currently has maximum sustained wind speeds of 130 miles per hour. The storm's status means it's considered a major hurricane on the Saffir-Simpson wind scale, capable of causing catastrophic damage to homes, uprooting trees, downing power lines, and rendering areas uninhabitable for weeks or months. All of Florida is under a state of emergency and authorities are urging residents to stockpile a week's worth of food and supplies, with the governor warning that the storm could be a multi-day event. Dorian is due to slow its forward speed in the coming days, allowing it to gain intensity over warm Caribbean waters and fuel the heavy rains, damaging wind and storm surge it's expected to deliver, CNN meteorologists said. A hurricane warning has been issued for the northwestern Bahamas, except for Andros Island, where a hurricane watch remains in effect, where Dorian is expected to hit on Sunday, the National Hurricane Center said. It is then forecast to roar toward the U.S. mainland on Monday evening into Tuesday morning, though experts warn that forecasts are subject to change. Dorian is expected to remain a powerful hurricane during the next few days. The core of Dorian should move over the Atlantic well, north of the southeastern and central Bahamas tonight and tomorrow, be near or over the northwestern Bahamas on Sunday, and be near the Florida east coast late on Monday, the center said on Friday. The Bahamian government has issued a hurricane warning for the northwestern Bahamas, while U.S. President has declared a state of emergency for the state of Florida. The National Hurricane Center said because Dorian is moving slowly at 17 kilometers per hour, it could produce prolonged rains, winds and storm surges, leading to life-threatening flash floods. Dorian has maximum sustained winds of 220 kilometers per hour. Category 4 storms are capable of what experts describe as catastrophic damage, destroying homes and buildings, ripping up roads and knocking down the trees and power lines. Florida National Guard Major General said 2,000 troops mobilized in the state on Friday, with another 2,000 joining them on Saturday. Flooding and travel chaos warning issued in UK as weekend brings huge thunderstorms. BBC Weather has forecast a drop in temperatures as heavy rains move across the country throughout the weekend, resulting in a yellow weather warning for flooding and travel disruption. BBC weather forecaster Nick Miller said, "We will all notice it turning cooler through the weekend just as September gets underway. Today, it is a north-south split. Scotland, Northern Ireland and Northern England with most of the cloud bringing some rain. The reason for that is because in the northern half of the UK you are closer to low pressure and this weather front will hang around there for 24 hours or so. It will then move southwards on Saturday with sunshine and showers following on behind. But close to that weather front, there is some rain to be had, especially in parts of western Scotland, northern Ireland and northwest England, into Cumbria in particular. Rain totals mounting through Friday night into... But close to that weather front, there is some rain to be had, especially in parts of western Scotland, northern Ireland and northwest England, into Cumbria in particular. Rain totals mounting through Friday night into Saturday morning through parts of northern Ireland and western and northern Scotland. There will be a range of totally here with yellow Met Office weather warnings in force, with the highest parts of these totals towards higher ground. Brewing tropical cyclone puts Philippines, China and Vietnam back on alert. As the tropics continue to be active across the globe, the West Pacific Ocean Basin looks to be no different in the coming week. Following behind Podul, which transfers the South China Sea earlier this week, the region could be the breeding ground of more tropical systems in the Western Pacific during the week ahead. Meteorologists are monitoring a broad area of low pressure near the northern Philippines, which will be moving into the South China Sea for the end of the weekend. Despite Podul moving across this area in recent days, water temperatures remain more than warm enough to foster further development of another tropical cyclone. Should the system strengthen to become a tropical storm in the Western Pacific Ocean, it would obtain the name Lingling. In the Philippines, this tropical system would be referred to Kabayan. Following development, it is quite possible that the weather pattern across southeastern Asia could steer the system to follow a similar track that Podul took earlier this week. Areas across Vietnam and Laos will be threatened by heavy tropical rainfall for the second time within about a week. Even if the budding Lingling were to deliver less rain to the region, the already wet ground could further exacerbate flooding problems and mudslides. One scenario that would spare Vietnam and Laos from a direct hit would involve this tropical threat stalling east of Vietnam, then turning northward and tracking into southeastern China next week. While northern Vietnam would still be at risk for local flooding in this scenario, the greatest risk of damaging winds and widespread flooding would shift to Hainan and coastal locations of southeastern China as well as Hong Kong. Moisture from this tropical system may then be pulled northeastward, bringing the risk of flooding to South Korea and Japan later next week. More tropical development is possible across the West Pacific Basin during the first half of September. Rains to continue in Kerala and coastal Karnataka or Maharashtra to observe good rains for next few days. Pune and Mumbai rains to revive. The rain intensity has increased over the geo states of Kerala and coastal Karnataka during the last 24 hours. Moderate to heavy showers lashed these areas. Moderate rains with one or two heavy spells are going on over coastal Karnataka since the last few days now. Kerala too has been receiving moderate showers, although the monsoon surge is active over the area, but now it's expected to shift towards north. Thus, rain activities will start reducing over Kerala, although a few moderate spells may continue for the next 2 to 3 days. Thereafter, the rain intensity may go down considerably over the state. However, coastal Karnataka will continue to receive rains. On the other hand, monsoon will remain subdued over interior Karnataka. Here, the rains will remain isolated and patchy. Bengaluru city is also gearing up to receive isolated light rains for the next 2 to 3 days. The west coast of Karnataka and its interior parts are likely to remain dry on the other hand. At present, Kerala is running rain surplus by 3%, while Karnataka is surplus by 17%. The upcoming rains will mean a change in the rain figures. Rain surplus of coastal Karnataka is likely to increase further in the coming days. However, rain surplus of Kerala might decrease to some extent. The meteorological division of Vidarbha has been receiving good rains lately. During the last 24 hours as well, moderate rains have occurred in many parts. Meanwhile, rainfall activities have increased in Konkan and Goa, with light to moderate rains with a few heavy spells making an appearance. Madhya Maharashtra too has witnessed a marginal increase in the weather activities. At present, a cyclonic circulation is over the Northeast Arabian Sea up to 5.4 kilometers above the sea level. Due to its influence, rains would intensify over Konkan and Goa region. Mumbai rains would also occur with moderate intensity for the next 2 to 3 days. Likewise, the rainfall activities would increase in Dahanu and Thane, while Vidarbha and Marathwada may witness moderate showers for the next 24 to 48 hours. Pune may observe light to moderate rains during the same span, but heavy showers are not likely to appear anytime soon. September 2nd onward, this scenario may change as the monsoon rains will decrease in Marathwada, but on and off rains will continue in parts of Vidarbha. A further increase in Mumbai rains is likely between September 3rd and 5th, wherein isolated heavy spells may lash the city. However, these rains would not be heavy so as to trigger flash floods, but waterlogging in the low-lying areas may create some trouble. That's all for now. For more news updates, stay tuned with us. It's Tomorrow News, Chandni Nebnani. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe.